Hi all, welcome to another tutorial on MATLAB. In this tutorial we will cover the concept of cruise control and different concept involved related to cruise control. So let's get started with the intro. Basic agenda of the discussion is first we will go through the controller modeling, how the controller is being designed. Then we will go into the plant modeling and development of both of them in the Simulink environment that we will implement in the third part, and at the end we will conclude our observations and key points while building the project. Basically we need to understand what is a controller modeling and what are the different key aspects of the controller modeling, and then we will start the modeling in detail. So basically a controller is a device which takes some input, and with the help of some control logic it gives the output which will be driving the plant. So the controller input should be coming from the plant, which is the actual system, and the controller output should go into the plant, which is actually the control signal that is helping the controller to control the plant and stay in the need, stay in the way it should perform the desired behavior. In this part of the modeling we will consider these of the assumptions into our design considerations. Here SW will be our switch, SW will be our cruise control switch, which can either be 1 or it can be either 0. 1 means on and 0 means off. There is another switch called start stop switch, which is representing a feature that is present in the car, which helps the vehicle to do start stop while the vehicle is in traffic, when the feature is being turned on. So in that case, one represents on for the feature and zero represents off for the feature. Here in the modeling, D is the distance that is to be measured with the help of the sensors that are present in the car. This distance can be considered as the distance between our car and another car for which we are measuring the distance. Here X represents the output state variable of different status from our state space model. Here X, if is equal to 1, then we are accelerating. When X is equal to -1, we are using deacceleration mode for the vehicle, and when X is equal to -2, then the vehicle will stop, and when X is equal to 0, it is doing nothing. FT represents the fault state. Basically when FT is equal to 0, then there is no fault present in the vehicle, so it will work fine. Basically this fault is more related to cruise control. So if the cruise control is having some fault detected, then it will be represent FT is equal to 0, FT is equal to 1, and if it is having no fault, then it will be represented that FT is equal to 0. When we create a state flow chart, usually we take the distance into consideration. in this case, and the top level view of the state chart will look like this. Here acceleration input is given to the plant, how much it should accelerate. Basically the plant model will be the vehicle design that will be having acceleration as the input, and D is the distance that is measured from the sensor, and that is also coming from the plant, and it is communicated to the state flow chart as a distance measurement. And this basic workflow works like this only. So there can be different states. If the state there will be two state that will be present and will be acting parallelly, and they will be executing parallelly also, and those boxes will be written with a dotted line, and one will be a fault detection system, and one will be a regular system that will be present in our design. So basically the fault regulating system will try to observe what are the faults present in the system currently when it is executing, and a regular system is our regular controller logic which will execute the control logic in the state flow chart. And this is the level at which the state flow will interact with the Simulink environment when it receives the distance in as an input and acceleration as an output. Now we basically will see how the logic is being implemented for the cruise control. First we will go into the regular logic, then we will go into the fault based logic that is presented here. So first we will go into the regular logic. First when the first state will be represented as the on state, and this state is represented as the off state. As these states are represented with a solid boundary, then it is called a sequential state, or it is called OR state, or decomposition for the state flow chart. And when this one will execute, this one will not execute. Means when on state is executed, then off state will not be executed. But the concept is little different for the dotted line, which we will discuss in later points in the discussion. So by default, when the system is getting turned on, it will go to the on state, and the on state will have a logic which will execute different logics based on decision variable x1. X1 will be the output from the state flow chart, and here by default the system goes to accelerate when cruise control is being turned on, and then when the distance is getting less when the distance is getting less than 5 meters, then we are trying to break by changing the excess output to -1, and then when this distance is getting equal to 5 meters by brake being applied, as we know that the brake being applied distance will increase as the speed of our vehicle will reduce, and the speed of other vehicle will stay constant. So this will result in an increase in the distance. So when distance is equal to 5 meters, then we go to do nothing state. So when distance is again more than 8 meters, then we try to accelerate the vehicle. So this way our braking, acceleration and do nothing state will work. In another way, if the vehicle is braking and the braking distance is getting again less than 2 meters, and in acceleration also, if it is getting less than 2 meters, then the vehicle will try to stop, the cruise control will try to stop the vehicle by changing the output x as -2. Suppose we are at on state and we want to go to the off state, then in that case we will be checking these two conditions. If any of the condition is being satisfied, then we will go to the off state. If the cruise control switch is off, then we will go to the off state. Then if start stop button is turned on, then we will go to the off state. And again, from the off state, if the both of the reverse condition is being satisfied, then we will again go back to on state. So this is how our regular logic works in our state flow. And next we will look into the fault detection logic that is present in our state flow chart. Next, this is the fault detection part. And when the vehicle is working normally, then it will be in the initial fault part. But when the vehicle went to fault condition, then FT will become equal to 1. And along with that, if the FT is staying for around 2 seconds as equal to 1, then we will go to the stop simulation part. And here the vehicle will stop the simulation. Here we will stop the simulation, and which is equivalent to the vehicle stopping. So here, as you can see, that we are defining a condition in the transition from initial fault state to fault state with the help of the condition is being defined with the help of square bracket, and the and logic is being used because it is not a bitwise logic operation. It is a logical operation. If we have used one and, then it will be a bitwise and operation. So in this case we will look into the next slide. In the controller modeling part, we have gone through all these points, how a controller will work like, and what are the different input and output for a controller, how it will be looking like from a top view for a state flow, and how distance is taken as an input, and how acceleration is given to the system in different forms, like x1 = 1, x1 = -1, x is equal to -1, x is equal to 0, and x is equal to -2. Then also we have gone through what is a regular system and what is a faulty system. And as a dotted line, we have seen in both the regular and faulty system, we can see like both as we have discussed, the dotted line represents a parallel simulation, which can be either which can run parallelly. And when the regular system is running, a fault detection system will be running in parallelly to check whether the vehicle is in proper condition or not. And we have also gone through how a condition is being written inside a state flow chart, like in a square bracket with the help of different logical operator. And also we have gone through the state flow chart, in which I forgot to mention that EN represents the entry state of each of the chart, and stop, accelerate, brake, do nothing represents the name of the chart, and D represents the distance that is we are from the other vehicle. And we also have gone through the assumptions that we have considered while designing the state flow chart. So this brings us to the end of this video. In the next video, we will cover plant modeling, so stay subscribed.